Hello and welcome in TeachMax videos. Let us solve the examples on rectangular water tank now. Okay, so in previous lecture already we discussed the procedure how to design a rectangular water tank if L by B is less than 2, if L by B is greater than or equal to 2. Okay, so very important is design actions. Okay, so there are 6 steps already we discussed. Let us apply them in this given example. Okay, so if you observe this given example here, what is given? First of all, understand. So we have to design a rectangular water tank. In example, it is mentioned that design a square water tank. Square water tank resting on the ground. Okay, square water tank resting on ground. To store a 75,000 liters water, okay, use M30 and FE 500 grades of material. So this is given to you, fine. So for which we have to design a square water tank which is resting on the ground. So it is mentioned in the example. So definitely here L by B is less than 2, which is considered. Okay, so based on the question given, you can assume whether it is L by 2 is less than 2 or greater than 2. Okay, so here it is mentioned use square water tank. So here L and B is same. So it, of course, it is less than 2. Okay, so understand this. So we are going to use 6 steps. First step, design actions. Sorry, design constants and permissible stresses we consider. Okay, so permissible stresses that we will consider in the first step. Okay, so what will be the design constants for M30 and FE 500? We have to consider first of all modular ratio. For that, first of all consider permissible stresses. So using IS 3370 part 2, okay, IS 3370 part 2, first of all we consider sigma CBC for M30, okay, from table number. So it is available for permissible stresses in concrete, table number 2 of IS 3370 part 2. For M30 this value is 10. Okay, so this value is 10 MPa. Sigma CT is not required, but we'll still write in this. Okay, for M30 I think it is given in table number 1 and it is 1.5 for direct tension. Okay, so 1.5. so what is this sigma CT? Means the permissible direct tensile stress in concrete, direct tension in concrete. Okay, and last sigma ST, third value that we get from table number 4. Okay, for all HYSD bars this value is 130 MPa, means for FE 415, FE 500, we will use this 130 MPa. That's it. Okay, so this is design, these are the design constants, permissible stresses of the material that we consider. Now design constants, we have to calculate design constants now. Okay, for WSM. Okay, so here modular ratio, we know it is M sigma CBC upon M sigma CBC plus sigma ST. So I am directly putting the value. M modular ratio we have to calculate, sorry. So it is 280 upon 3 sigma CBC. This is the formula that we use. So first of all put the value in this, 280 divided by 3 into 10. So it is 9.33. Now find out remaining. Okay, now you will get K, then J, okay, then Q. So these three we have to calculate. So I am calculating directly. So what is K? M sigma CBC upon M sigma CBC plus sigma ST. Put the value, 9.33 into 10 plus 130. So that is denominator, and above 9.33 into 10 bracket close divide by answer. So it is 0.417. so you can say 0.42. okay, now J, 1 minus k by 3, so 1 minus 0.42 divided by 3, 0.86. Okay, so 0.86. What is q? Q we know, 1 half sigma cbc into kj. So 0.5 into sigma cbc 10 into k 0.42 into j 0.86. So here it is, it is 1.81. okay, 806 means 81. Fine, so we get so we get the first step in which permissible stresses and design constants. So what is the second step here? Second step is fixation of dimension. So fixation of dimensions. Now we have to decide the dimensions. So what are the dimensions we will decide? First thickness, and second is the size. Also, first of all we go with the size, because here size is not given, capacity is given. So if you observe square water tank, it is mentioned. So easily we can equate this. Okay, so L into B into H, L into B into H, you can equate to volume or capacity, and that capacity is 75,000 liters. So this divided by 10 raised to 3.